Good morning, student. I am Snehasi Kole, your physics teacher. Today we are going to discuss about magnets and electromagnets. A naturally occurring black colored substance called lodestone can attract a piece of iron kept nearby. In early days, the Greeks observed this property of lodestone, an oxide of iron called magnetite. This property of naturally occurring substance is called natural magnet. Magnets are also made artificially and in various shapes or size depending on their use. The branch of physics which deals with study of magnets and their properties and application is called magnetism. What is magnet and what materials are magnetic? There are two types of materials. One is magnetic materials and other is non-magnetic materials. Magnetic materials are those which are attracted by a magnet or can be transformed into magnet by special means. And non-magnetic materials are those which are not attracted by the magnets. Example, plastic, rubber, paper, pencil, etc. In this example, you have to find out which one are magnetic material and which one are not. As you can see, here a magnet which is shown in red color and its poles are shown as North Pole and South Pole, which attracts cobalt, nickel and iron. So cobalt, nickel and irons are magnetic material as they are attracted by the magnet. But gold, magnesium, copper, silver, aluminium, zinc, these metals or materials does not attracted by the magnets. So these materials are non-magnetic materials. So in general, there are only three magnetic materials, that are iron, cobalt and nickel. In this slide, the atomic number and mass number of magnetic materials are given. Methods of magnetization. The process by which magnetic substance such as iron is converted into magnet is called magnetization. Number 1. Stroking a magnet along the paper clip from one end to the other and then starting from the same place and repeat the movement. By this means we can make the clip magnetic. Number 2. Holding a nail in a magnetic field and hitting it with a hammer will also make the nails magnetic. In the third topic, putting a magnetic material in a strong magnetic field will make the substance also magnetic. What causes magnetism in a magnet? In a simple word, why some of the materials are magnetic and others are non-magnetic? As you have heard that in an atom there are three basic particles, that are proton, neutrons and electrons. Among them, proton and neutron are made up of quarks. These are the quark configuration of neutron, where one up and two down quark are combined to form a neutron. And in this case, two up quark and one down quark combines to form a proton. So these are the two protons and these are the two neutrons. Neutrons are electrically neutral and protons are electrically positively charged. And here the electron which revolves around the nucleus, which is composed of neutron and proton in the center region of an atom. You can compare this atomic model with the solar system, like sun in the center of the solar system. Here sun is compared with the nucleus and the electron are compared with the different planet. Like planets revolve around the sun, which situated at the center of the solar system. Like that way, nucleus is also situated in the center of the atom and electrons revolve in different orbit. When Earth rotates around the sun, it also has a spin which we call diurnal motion. Like this way, electron also consists spin during their orbital motion, and due to this they produce a current and hence a magnetic field in the atom. So in most of the atom, the magnetic field generated by each electron cancel out each other. As here you can see, there are two electrons represented by two arrows. One is up arrow and one is down arrow. These arrow represents the up spin and down spin of electron. If one electron is up spin and one electron is down spin, then their total magnetic field is cancelled out. In most of the atom, their magnetic fields are cancelled out. But in case of iron, you can see here the every orbital is filled with two electron, but here there is four electron which is unpaired. In few atoms like iron, cobalt and nickel, there are unpaired electrons whose spin can align and give the atoms an overall magnetic field. In the previous slide, we have discussed about how magnetic field generated in an atom, and in this slide we will discuss about how magnetic field can be generated in an substance. As we know that a substance is composed of numerous number of atoms, when these atoms align themselves according to their magnetic field in the same direction, then we have a domain. Here in a total substance, there are four domains are shown in the four different color. These are the one domain where the magnetic field of all the atoms are in a fixed direction, and in this atom also the magnetic field of the atom are in a fixed direction, but other than the yellow ones. So in this way, total magnetic field of the substance become zero. So the substance generally does not show any magnetic property like iron or cobalt. As you have seen that a iron nail does not show a magnetic property in general, but when the iron nail is placed near to a magnet or in contact to a magnet, then it shows magnetic properties. Here we want to say that generally the iron nail does not show magnetic property due to sum of the magnetic field of the all domains becomes zero. Hence, the total magnetic field becomes zero, so it does not show any magnetic property. But when there is an external magnetic field, then all the domains align themselves in the same direction with the external magnetic field. Hence, which in the absence of external magnetic field does not show magnetic property, but when it keep in an external magnetic field, then it show magnetic property due to alignment in the direction of the magnetic field. If we consider this is a magnetic material, and inside this there consist of numerous numbers of magnets, and they are aligning in haphazard orientation, and due to their haphazard orientation, the total magnetic field cancel each out. Hence, it does not show any magnetic property. When there is an external magnetic field, then all the tiny magnets inside the magnetic material align themselves in a order of the external magnetic field, and due to this there is a neat magnetic field of the material, and hence the magnetic material which previously or in the absence of magnetic field does not show magnetic property, but in the presence of magnetic field it shows its magnetic property due to alignment in the same direction. So in this slide we are going to discuss the topic that you cannot have magnetic monopoles. Mono means single, that means only north or only south cannot exist. If we break a magnet in two pieces, then it will produce two separate magnets in which both of them consist of their north pole and south pole. So monopole does not exist. Now in this context we are going to discuss about what is force. So force is a push or pull that causes change in motion. A force field is the pattern in the space or imaginary pattern in the space how that force is felt by other object as shown in imaginary lines or imaginary ray. Fundamental force arises from fundamental properties of matter, like the force gravity arises from a fundamental property like mass of the substance. Like mass attracts other mass, hence this type of force is known as gravity, and which is discovered by Newton. And here is another force, that is electric force or electrostatic force, which arises from a fundamental property of a matter, that is charge. There is two kinds of charge, one is positive and one is negative. The same charge repel each other, like in this one, the direction of their force, you can see that is repelling each other. And in case of opposite charge, they can attract each other. Like two charges, positive and negative, here we have two poles, that one is north pole and other is south pole. Field lines, which are the imaginary line in which direction the force will act, will always point it from north pole to south pole outside the bar magnet, and from south pole to north pole inside the magnet. So all the magnetic field lines are closed loop, like outside north pole to south pole and inside south pole to north pole. Discussed earlier that a force field is the pattern in space, how that force is felt by the other object. Hence, in the next slide, the force is felt by the iron filing in this pattern. This is the magnetic field or pattern of the magnetic field. What is magnetic field? The region around a magnet where it has magnetic effect is called magnetic field. That means, in the region outside the magnet where other magnetic material or magnets can feel the magnetic force, that region is known as magnetic field. Here the arrow shows the direction of the magnetic field lines or imaginary lines, and here you can see the magnetic field is strongest at the poles like south pole or north pole region, and weaker at the middle portion. If we put two bar magnets with their north poles together, then the magnetic pattern or magnetic field lines will look like this, that here is a region where no force will act, and this portion or this region is known as neutral point. As you can see here, the magnetic field lines in this region due to the first magnet is repulsed by the magnetic field lines of the second magnet. Hence, we can see that the two same pole will repel each other. If we put opposite poles together, then we can see force will act between the two poles, and hence they will attract each other. Here are few definitions related to bar magnets. The point here where the attraction or repulsion force of a bar magnet is maximum is known as magnetic pole. Here the two poles of the magnet, one is north pole and another is south pole. The poles of a magnet does not exist at the edge of the bar magnet. It's situated at a distance inside the bar magnet. This point is the south pole and this point is the north pole, where all the magnetic field lines are coinciding with each other. If we join these two poles with an imaginary line, which is shown in this dotted line, this line is called magnetic axis of the bar magnet, and the perpendicular line with the magnetic axis is known as equator of the magnet, and the distance between these two poles are known as magnetic length. The magnetic length of this bar magnet is 2L as shown here, and magnetic length is 0.84 times the geometrical length, which is the total length of the magnet from this end to this end. Here are few properties of magnet which are listed. Magnets attract or repel other magnets to exert a force. Like poles repel each other and opposite poles attract each other, as you have seen in the previous two slides. Number 2 point, magnet attracts other magnetic material. Due to this property, we divide the material into two categories, that is, one is magnetic material and another is non-magnetic materials. And a magnet must have two distinct poles each. That means it cannot have monopole, or monopole does not exist. And in this context, you need to know that to apply magnetic force, they do not need to touch each other. So it is a non-contact force, and magnets can turn other magnetic material like iron, nickel or cobalt into temporary magnets. There are other few properties like attractive properties of magnet, that a magnet can attract a small piece of magnet or magnetic material towards itself. Number 2, directive properties. A freely suspended magnet always points in the north-south direction. The end pointing towards north is called north-seeking pole or north pole of the magnet, and the pole or end which points towards the south is called south-seeking pole or the south pole. Number 3, law of magnetic poles. Like poles repel each other, as we have mentioned earlier, and unlike poles attract each other. Like north pole and north pole, or south pole and south pole will repel each other, and north pole south pole will attract each other. Number 4, pair property. The magnetic poles always exist in pair. All the magnets have a north pole and a south pole. If a given magnet is cut into a number of small pieces, each piece is still a complete magnet having both the poles. It is impossible to have an monopole or an isolated magnetic poles, that is, only north or only south pole does not exist. Number 5, repulsion is the sure test of magnetism. In this point, all the magnets attract opposite poles of other magnets, and also a few substances like iron, nickel and cobalt. Thus, if an unknown substance is attracted by a magnet, we cannot sure whether it is a magnet or magnetic material. But like poles of magnets repel each other. Hence, if there is repulsion between unknown substance and a magnet, we can be sure that unknown substance is a magnet. Number 5, property of induction. A magnet can induce magnetism in substances like soft iron, cobalt or nickel. What is magnetic induction? So when a magnet is kept near another magnetic material, due to the influences of the bar magnet, the magnetic material converted into temporary magnet, and this phenomena is known as magnetic induction. And due to induction, and same pole will arise at the far end and the opposite pole will arise at the near end. William Gilbert proposed in 16,000 that Earth itself a huge magnet, and he predicted that the Earth would be found to have magnetic poles. The branch of physics that deals with the study of Earth magnetic field is called terrestrial magnetism or geomagnetism. Geo means earth. It is observed that when a magnet is suspended freely, it aligns itself in the north-south direction. In the earlier days, it was assumed that it was the pole star which was responsible for this effect, but later it was proved by Gilbert that the effect was due to the magnetic field of the Earth. Earth acts as a huge magnet. The exact cause of this magnetism is unknown, but for simplicity, it is assumed that a huge bar magnet in the interior of the Earth is responsible for the magnetism. The north pole of this magnet is found to be very close to the geographical south pole, and the south pole of the magnet is found to be very close to the geographical north. Hence, the magnetic meridian and the geographical meridian do not coincide. This is the magnetic meridian and this is the geographical meridian. There is a gap of an angle of 11.5 degree. But in recent days, the cause of this magnetic field, it says that, as we know, inside the earth there is molten iron in the earth's outer core that causes the most of the earth magnetic field. Now here we come to the point, electricity and magnetism. Electric current is moving charge. That means the rate of moving charge is known as electric current. If we put a compass around the circuit, then we can see that when there is no current in the circuit, then the compass will align themselves, but all the compass will align in the north-south direction. But when we switch on the circuit, then a current flows through the circuit, and then we see that the direction of the compass will change, and the direction of the compass will change if there is a magnetic field. So we can say that when we switch on the circuit, due to the flow of current, a magnetic field is produced, due to which the direction of the compass is changed. Hence, it is proved that due to the flow of current, a magnetic field is produced. How the magnetic field or magnetic field lines looks in case of current carrying conductor? As you can see, here is a conductor in the brown color, and current is flowing from right side to the left side, and due to this a magnetic field is produced, which are shown in the white color. So as you can see here, a solenoid is made by spiraling a insulated copper wire around a iron or iron nail, and if we pass current through the solenoid, then a magnetic field will produce, and due to this magnetic field of the solenoid, the domains or the small magnets inside this magnetic material or the iron nail are aligned in a proper direction, and hence this iron nail becomes a temporary magnet. If we cut off the current in the circuit, then the iron nail will lose its magnetic property. So when the current is passed through this solenoid, only for that time this iron nails will behave like a magnet. Now here is a task that you have to make a solenoid or electromagnet by coiling an insulated copper wire around the iron nail and connecting it with a battery. You can make an electromagnet at home, and with this electromagnet you can do this experiment at your home. Now the question arises, how the strength of the electromagnet can be increased? The strength of the electromagnet can be increased in two ways. Number one, if we increase the number of turns here, if we increase the number of turns, then the strength of the electromagnet will increase. And the other or second way to increase the strength of the electromagnet is to increase the current by increasing the number of battery. Here is another example of electromagnets. This is electric or magnetic crane. With the help of magnetic crane, heavy loads like iron scraps, cars, etc. can be lifted by passing current through the electromagnets. The crane moves the load to the desired place, and if the current is stopped, the heavy load which was attached to the electromagnet falls down in our desired place. So what are the advantages of electromagnet over the permanent magnet? If we use permanent magnet instead of electromagnet, then it will attract magnetic substance or the iron scrap, but it will not place the scrap in the desired place, as it will not demagnetize itself. So the iron scrap will remain hangs in the crane. But if we use electromagnet, if we cut off the current, then the electromagnet is demagnetized and iron scraps or the car will place at the spot where we wanted. Here is a diagram shows how the electric doorbell works. As you can see, here is a switch, and if we connect this switch, then a current will flow through this conductor, and due to the flow of the conductor, these bars will become magnet, and due to this, they will attract this iron bar, and due to attraction of the iron bar, this iron bar will move towards this electromagnet, and due to this hammer will hit the bell. Here is another example of electromagnets, and another example of electromagnets is electromagnetic relay. In this circuit, here is a motor of car, lifts or other large electrical appliances which uses a huge amount of current, and if you want to control this current, then we use an electromagnetic key. If we switch on this circuit, then this electromagnet will start working and attracts this rod towards itself. Due to this, the circuit of the motor closed and the current will flow through the motor and motor start. And if we switch off this key, then this electromagnet is demagnetized and releases this rod. Hence, this circuit is open and the motor stops. In this way, we can control the usage of current through this motor. Few uses of electromagnets are listed. As you can see, in our house, there are many appliances in which electromagnets or magnets are in use. As you can see here, to make a motor, we need a magnet also. And here is also another uses of magnets which related to the car system. Now, in this topic, we are going to discuss about the magnetic field of Earth and Sun. As I discussed earlier, that Earth has a magnetic field of its own, and like this, Sun also have its magnetic field, and the other planets in the solar system and in this universe also have their magnetic fields. Those who are more interested to know about Sun's magnetic field, I am going to give an external link about the magnetic field of Sun in my description box. In this figure, this is the Earth, and outside the Earth, there is some donut-shaped region of charged particle are known as Van Allen belts. This is formed due to the Earth's magnetic fields, which opposes the solar wind coming from the Sun, which are consist of highly charged particle which are moving with a high velocity towards Earth, and the Earth's magnetic field prevents us from the solar flare. And if there is no magnetic field around Earth, then the life on Earth could not exist due to this solar wind, and the temperature of the Earth's surface will become nearly 5 to 6,000 degrees Celsius. As this was first experienced by Van Allen, so the name of these belts are Van Allen belts or radiation belts. This is the Earth, the red lines are the Earth's magnetic fields. The Earth magnetic fields will prevent the solar wind to hit the Earth's surface, and it will deflect the solar wind in the sideways, so the Earth does not affected by the solar wind. Thank you.